Hello everyone, welcome to PM Networking. Today in this video I am going to show you how you will avoid proxy ARP and recursive lookup while configuring static routing. So when we configure static routing, there is two problems. First one is proxy ARP, and second problem is recursive lookup. Right. So today I am going to show you how you will avoid these two problems while configuring static routing. So first, as you can see over here, we have three LAN, right? This is my LAN 1, this is my LAN 2, this is my LAN 3. So I am running network in LAN 1 10.10.10.0/24, right? And I configure IP address on this interface, fast ethernet 0/1 is 10.10.10.10, right? So what will be the default gateway for these two users? Default gateway for these users will be 10.10.10.10, right? And I will configure IP address to PC1 is 10.1 and PC2 to 10.2, okay? In LAN 2, I am running network 20.10.10.0/24, and I will configure 10.10 on this interface, right? 20.10 on this interface. And 20.10.10.1 on PC3 and 10.2 on PC4. Okay, and after that, I will configure 30.10 on this interface and 30.1, 30.2 to the PC5 and PC6. And I am running network 192.168.10.0/30 between router 1 and router 2. So to avoid the wastage of IPv4 IP address, I am using /30, and here between R2 and R3 I am running network 192.168.10.4/30. So actually I already configure IP address on R1, R2 and R3. Let me show you. So IP interface brief. As you can see over here, there is on fast ethernet 0/0 IP address is 192.168.10.10, right? Status is up, protocol is up, right? Now fast ethernet 0/1 10.10, status up, protocol up, right? But let me show you routing table of R1. So IP route, so there is entry of directly connected network only, right? There is entry of directly connected network only, so this network is not able to communicate with this network, right? And this network is not able to communicate with this network as well, right? So we need to inject 20's network in R1 routing table, right? And 30's network in R1 routing table, and we need to inject 10 and 30 in R2 routing table, and we have to inject 10 or 20 in R3 routing tables, right? So when we configure a static routing using exit interface, right? Let me configure a static routing using exit interface first, okay? So go to R1, IP route 20.10.10.0, submit mask will be 255.255.0, and fast ethernet 0/0 is exit interface, right? Guys, you can see the routing table of R1. In routing table of R1, so IP route, right? There is entry for 20's network, right? Yes, there is entry. Here you can see S means static routings. How this router learn 20 network? By a static routing, right? But this router knows that 20.10.10.0 is directly connected to my fast ethernet 0/0, but it's not right, it's fake information, because 20's network is directly connected to R1, not to R2, sorry. 20's network is directly connected to R2, not R1. But in routing table of R1, there is entry that 20's network is directly connected to fast ethernet 0/0. So that's the reason that is proxy ARP. This is proxy ARP. So that's the reason proxy ARP is enabled on the every interface of router. That's why this network can communicate with this network, right? Let me ping 10.2 from PC1. Ping 20.10.10.1. So guys, it will not ping, right? Because there is no any entry in R2 routing table for 10 networks, right? So let me configure static routing for 10 network. Okay, configure. Let me show you IP address first. So IP interface brief, right? So as you can see over here, on fast ethernet 0/0 IP address is 192.168.10.2. on fast ethernet 0/1 IP address is 192.168.10.5. on interface fast ethernet 1/0 IP address is 20.10.10.10, right? Now let me show you I routing table of R2. So IP root. So there is entry for 10, right? So actually I run command IP root 10.10.10.0 255.255.255.0 and exit interface is fast ethernet 0/0, right? So guys, you see, let me show you proxy ARP. So interface, so IP interface, so IP interface fast ethernet 0/0. So guys, you can see over here proxy ARP is disabled, right? But by default proxy ARP is enabled on every interface of router. So I manually disable proxy ARP on this interface. Let me ping from here 20.10.10.1. so it will not ping. Why? Because I disable proxy ARP on R2. So let me enable proxy ARP. How we can enable proxy ARP on interface fast ethernet 0/0? IP proxy ARP, right? Now let me check on R1 proxy ARP is enabled or not. Configure interface fast ethernet 0/0 IP proxy ARP, right? Now PC1 can communicate with 20.1. Okay, it's again not pinging, just wait. So IP interface fast ethernet 0/0. So proxy ARP is enabled or not? Proxy ARP is enabled, right? Let me check on R2. So IP interface fast ethernet 0/0. So proxy ARP is enabled. So why it's not pinging? Yeah, it's pinging, right? It's pinging. So why it's pinging? Because of proxy ARP. There is problem of proxy ARP. What is proxy ARP? As I had discussed in static routing while I was configuring static routing. So what is proxy ARP and what is recursive lookup, right? So today I am going to show you how you will avoid this proxy ARP problem and recursive lookup problem. Let me show you what is recursive lookup again. So we need to remove this static routing from your IP root. So let me type no IP root 20.10.10.0 255.255.255.0. Okay, so now you can see there is no any entry for 20 network in their routing table. So there is no any entry for. Let me remove static routing from R2 as well. Go to global configure mode, no IP root 10.10.10.0 255.255.255.0 and fast ethernet 0/0, right? So you can see there is no any entry for 10 network, so IP route. So there is no any entry for 10 network. Let me configure a static routing using exit interface. Oh sorry, next hop IP address. So I am on R1, IP route 420.10.10.0 255.255.255.0, and exit interface is next hop IP address is, sorry, not exit interface, next hop IP address. Next hop IP address is 192.168.10.2. Okay, now check, let me show you the routing table of R1. So IP route. So yes, there is entry for 20 network, but there is entry via 192.168.10.2. So router will check their routing table again to forward 192.168.10.2 from which interface I have to out this traffic, from which interface I should out the traffic to forward this traffic to 192.168.10.2, because router has to know exit interface to forward the traffic, right? So there is no any information about exit interface, right? So router will again check their routing table, right? And they see 192.168.10.10.0 is directly connected to my fast ethernet 0/0, and then router will out this traffic from fast ethernet 0/0. So how many times router check their routing table? 2 times. So whenever router check more than once to their routing table to forward a traffic, that is known as recursive lookup, right? Whenever router check their routing table more than once, that is recursive lookup. So here is problem of recursive lookup. Let me remove the static routing from here, and then I will show you how to configure a static routing so you can avoid proxy up as well as recursive lookup. So let me remove a static routing first. No IP route 20.10.10.0 255.255.255.0, and next hop IP address is 192.168.10.10.2, right? So there is no any entry, so IP route, so there is no any entry, right? So now I will configure a static routing in such a way that the problem of recursive lookup and proxy ARP will not occur, right? So what I will do, I will configure a static routing for 20's network and for 30's network on R1. For 20 and for 30, I will provide exit interface as well as next hop IP address, right? Exit interface as well as next hop IP address. So router will see that exit interface is fast ethernet 0/0 and next hop IP address is 192.168.10.2. So router will not attach, not generate ARP for 20.1, right? And router will not check twice their routing table to forward traffic in 20 networks, right? So let me inject 20 network and 30 network in R1 routing table, and 10 network and 30 network in R2 routing table, and 10 or 20 in R3 routing table, right? So let me configure and then I will show you the communication. Okay, go to R1. Okay, wait. To R1, configure terminal, IP route 20.10.10.0, 255.255.255.0, fast ethernet 0/0, and next hop IP address is 192.168.10.2, right? Now let me configure static routing for 30's network as well. IP route 30.10.10.0, 255.255.255.0, exit interface fast ethernet 0/0, and next hop IP address is 192.168.10.2. Let me show you the routing table of R1 now. So IP route, right? So guys, as you can see over here, there is route for 20 network and 30 network, right? So you can see 20.10.10.0 is via 192.168.10.2, and exit interface is fast ethernet 0/0. So now R1 will not generate R4 20.1, and R1 not check their routing table twice to forward traffic, right? So now there is no problem of proxy ARP as well as no problem of recursive lookup, right? And let me configure on R2 static routing as well, right? So go to config, global configure mode, and then IP route 10.10.10.0 255.255.255.0. Fast Ethernet exit interface will be 0/0, right? Exit interface will be 0/0 for 10 network, and next hop IP address will be 192.168.10.1, right? Now IP route, let me configure static routing for 30 networks as well. For 30 network, so 30.10.10.0 subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Exit interface will be fast ethernet 0/1. For 30 network, exit interface will be 0/1, and for 10 network, exit interface will be 0/0. Am I right? Now next hop IP address, next hop IP address will be 192.168.10.6, right? Enter. Now you can see the routing table of R2, so IP route, right? So for 10 network, there is entry for 10 network via 192.168.10.10, and to forward traffic to 10.2, exit interface is fast ethernet 0/0, right? In the same way for 30 network, exit interface is 10.6, and next hop IP address is 10.6, and exit interface is fast ethernet 0/1, right? So now R2 will not generate R4 30.1 directly, and not check their routing table twice to forward a traffic in 30 network on 10 or 10 networks, right? So let me configure same static routing on R3 as well. Okay, so IP route 10.10.10.0 255.255.255.0 exit interface is fast ethernet 0/0, and next hop IP address is 192.168.10.5. am I right? And for 20 network, let me write 20. Exit interface will be same, and next hop IP address will be same, right? You can see the routing table of R3 as well. So IP route, so there is entry for 10 network and for 20 network, right? With next hop IP address and exit interface. Now this PCCAL can communicate with 10.1 and 30.1, right? So let me configure 30.1 on PC5. So IP 30.10.10.1/24, and default gateway will be 30.10.10.10, right? Checking for duplicate IP address, and IP configuration is done on PC5. So let me ping from PC1. Wait. Let me ping from PC1. Ping 30.10.10.1. So it's pinging, guys. Yes, it's pinging. Let me ping 20.1. Ping 20.10.10.1. timeout, and it's pinging, right? So this is how we configure a static routing to avoid recursive lookup and proxy ARP. Give exit interface as well as next hop IP address to the router. Okay, then router will install that route in the routing table with exit interface as well as next hop IP address, right? Both information will be available for remote network. So router will not generate ARP directly and not check twice their routing table to forward traffic, right? So this is how you can avoid proxy ARP and recursive lookup in a static routing. Okay, hope this video is helpful for you. If I am right, please like the video, and if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe this channel, because I am uploading one video every day, right? So if you want to do CCNA or in networking, if you want to make your career in networking field, you can click on bell icon so that you will notify whenever I will upload the video. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.